Hello everyone, what is up? Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Sierra and today is a Vlogmas video. I'm really excited about this one. It's just going to be kind of a simple sit down Christmas tag kind of thing. Just going to answer some questions about Christmas and how I feel about it, my favorites, my least favorites, how I celebrate, all that kind of good stuff. So without further ado, let's get started. So, question number one, favorite Christmas movie. This is probably so basic and everyone's gonna be like, why is that your favorite Christmas movie? But Elf, I think it's so funny. I know a lot of people hate that movie and think it's like the worst Christmas movie ever, but I think it's hilarious. And it's the only one that I know I watch every single year. I really don't watch that many movies, and like honestly, a lot of the Christmas movies I probably haven't even seen. Like I've only seen one of the Home Alones, I think, and I just watched that one last year, so. Really, I'm kind of uncultured, so that might be the reason for my answer being Elf, but there you have it. Have you ever had a white Christmas? I think I've had one. In my 21 years of life, there's maybe been like one or two, but usually it's like 70 degrees on Christmas where I live, and it's honestly annoying. I would love to have more white Christmases, but that's just kind of how it is. Do you start Christmas shopping on Black Friday or wait until the last minute? I would say it's kind of a mixture of both. It just kind of depends because I do love a good sale, but I'm not really the type to like go out to the store on Black Friday. I do a lot of my shopping online, so I definitely don't wait for the last minute to do that because I want to make sure it gets here in time. I would say it's a mixture of both. When does your family put up your Christmas tree and who decorates it? It honestly just depends. Usually we put it up like right after Thanksgiving. Like I think this year we did it the weekend after Thanksgiving, so like Thanksgiving and then that Saturday. Usually I think that's when we do it, but my mom is always like so aggravated because she used to like decorate it by herself because no one would help her, and so then she would be like, I don't want to put it up. But as I've gotten older, I feel like I've helped more, but a lot of times she would do it like an hour away at school or whatever the case would be. So I would say it's a mixture of mainly my mom, and then sometimes over the years I've helped her. Is your Christmas tree real or fake? So at my house it's fake, but at my grandparents' house we always had a real tree, so that was fun. Like when I was younger, I would go with them to pick it out. We never went to like a Christmas tree farm that I remember. It was usually like they were already cut down and it like next to a parking lot kind of thing, but it was still fun. So my house there, it's fake, and then at my grandparents' house it's real. Does your family have a special holiday recipe that you like to make? I've never cooked for the holidays myself, but my Nana makes this breakfast casserole, and like I'm pretty sure it's the easiest thing in the world to make, but I love it, and I'm actually gonna do a vlog of me making it because I love it so much. So are you a professional present wrapper or do you fail miserably? I wouldn't say I'm a professional by any means, but I don't think that I fail miserably either. Sometimes I end up having way too much paper or whatever, or like if I have a gift that's like a weird shape, that can be a little more difficult, but I love wrapping presents, so I've gotten pretty good at it over the years, I feel like. What tops your tree? So I'm pretty sure we have an angel that goes on top. I could be wrong. Or maybe we used to have an angel, but now it's just like a bow and then it hangs down. Which I don't really like the bow, but my mom likes it, so that's what we use. You have been granted one Christmas wish, what would it be? Honestly, this year, my Christmas wish would just to actually be able to spend Christmas with my family, and that like is kind of like sad, but it's true because my Poppy is in an assisted living facility, so like he's not even allowed to leave, so I've only seen him like a handful of times since Corona started. Like they've been there since March without being able to leave, so that really sucks because Christmas at my Nana and Poppy's house has always been like the most exciting thing. Like we always like have tons of presents there. Like our family comes and we just hang out, eat, like watch TV. Like it's just chill and it's so much fun. Like I love it there. And so it sucks that we're probably not going to be able to do that this year. So that would be my Christmas wish, to actually get to spend Christmas with my family. Because honestly, what's the point of Christmas if you don't get to spend it with the people that you love? What is your favorite Christmas song? I'm not gonna lie to y'all, I freaking hate Christmas music. It plays entirely too much and I just really don't like it. So I do like All I Want for Christmas Is You, just because it's like fast and catchy and I can sing it and like be stupid when I sing it, but like most of the other Christmas songs I can't stand. So sorry to anyone that loves Christmas music, but it's just not me. I love Christmas with everything in me, but I hate the music. Do you open your presents on Christmas Eve or Christmas morning? with my parents, I open them on Christmas morning. My grandparents, I used to open them on Christmas Day. And then like we would have like a huge family get together Christmas Eve, and I would always get to take one present to that to open, but then everything else we would open on Christmas Day. So usually we just open stuff on Christmas Day. Candy canes or gingerbread men? I would say candy canes, just because, I don't know, I think your breath smells better after, I don't know. Have you ever made a snowman? Yes, but not at Christmas, because like I said before, it doesn't ever snow on Christmas where I live. So what is at the top of your list this Christmas? A lot of the things that I'm asking for Christmas are clothes, and then like vlogging stuff, because I want to have better equipment and not slow down my computer so much when I edit. But that and clothes, I feel like clothes is always like the number one thing I ask for. So yeah, clothes and vlogging stuff. Do you have any Christmas traditions? Honestly, not really, I wouldn't say. Like I said, the thing with how I would take one present on Christmas Eve, I guess you could consider that a tradition, but like, there's nothing that stands out to me that it's like, yes, we do this every Christmas at this time or whatever. So not really. Kind of wish we did, because I think that would be cool, like something to look forward to every year, but we don't, that I can think of. Are you on the naughty list or the nice list this year? I would say I'm on the nice list this year. Usually, I would say I'm always on the nice list. I have my moments, but I'm definitely an overall nice person, regardless of what anyone that may have known me before would tell you. I'm a much nicer person these days, I promise. So I think I'm on the nice list. Do you prefer giving gifts or receiving gifts? Honestly, giving gifts, I absolutely love giving presents. Like, I feel like I'm literally so good at it, and I've been told that I'm very good at it, because a lot of times like people will tell me things that they want, and I'm like, they don't really want that. That's just something that they're telling me they want so that they don't say, I don't know, or something like that. So like, for example, this wasn't for Christmas, but for Jonathan's birthday, he had been talking about like the previous winter. His birthday is literally in July, so in the middle of summer. But the winter before his birthday, he was talking about how his snowboard was like getting a little too small, so he would like, his toes would hit the snow, and like, they're not supposed to do that. So for his birthday, I bought him a new snowboard. Obviously, he didn't tell me that he wanted a new snowboard. He like completely had forgotten about it, but I was like, he mentioned it several times during the winter, like, and I know him, like, he didn't do it to be like, oh, give me a snowboard. But like, that was a cool gift, and I was really proud of myself for thinking of that in the middle of the summer. So I would say I'm a very good gift giver. I typically try to give people things that are more like personal, instead of just like, oh, I found this in the dollar section at the Walmart and it was like a stocking stuffer thing. Like, that's lame. So I try to get people stuff that like actually fits their personality, or something that they'll actually use, not just like something stupid to say that I gave them a gift. What is the worst Christmas memory that you have? So I think I was in the 7th grade. I was definitely in middle school. I was like dog sick on Christmas. I was literally like throwing up, like didn't even want to get out of bed. It was the worst Christmas of my life because I was sick, so sick. And like, I don't ever hardly get sick, so that really sucked that I was sick on Christmas. That was the worst. Like, we had to postpone our Christmas get together with my parents, like with my grandparents, because I was sick. So that pretty much sucked. What holiday traditions are you looking forward to the most this year? So as I mentioned before, like, my family doesn't really have any traditions, I would say, but Jonathan's family, they go get a real Christmas tree. So that was the first time I'd ever gone to like an actual Christmas tree farm, was last year with him and his dad. So that was a lot of fun, and I think we're gonna do that again this year. So I don't know, I just love real Christmas trees. Like, I don't know what it is, but I just think it's cool to like fluff it out and like, you know, go up, pick out the one you want, cut it down, bring it home, decorate, like all the things. I just think it's cool. I mean, I guess it would be easier to have a fake one, because like, you don't have to worry about watering it or like the leaves falling off or whatever, but I just love real Christmas trees. So that is something I'm looking forward to, is picking out a real Christmas tree again. What do you leave Santa as a snack on Christmas Eve? So obviously I don't do that anymore. But when I was little, you know, everyone leaves him like milk and cookies. And my mom was like, well, he gets milk and cookies from every other house, we should leave him something different. And I'm like, that's a great idea, Mom. Like, he will really appreciate that he didn't get milk and cookies for the 500th house in a row. And so we would leave him Cheerwine. And if you're not from the South, you probably don't know what that is, but it's just soda. It's like a red cherry type soda. So Cheerwine and Cherry Yum Yum, which is this thing that my mom makes. It's like graham cracker crust, Cool Whip, and then it's like cherry pie filling and maybe a couple other things, but those are like the three main ingredients. Mom makes that every Christmas. So we would leave him cherry wine and cherry yum yum. And it was not until I was older that I realized, obviously, it was not for Santa. It was for my mom. I don't know why that never clicked in my head, but it didn't. So yeah, I always left him cherry wine and cherry yum yum, or cherry wine and some other kind of dessert that was not cookies. How long did you believe in Santa Claus? So honestly, I think I was probably like 11 or 12. Like, I feel like I was kind of old to still be believing in Santa Claus. And this is kind of a funny story. So the reason that I stopped believing in Santa Claus is because Santa gave me a sleeping bag. For whatever reason, I asked for a sleeping bag, I think. And Santa Claus gave me one. And I, like, brought it back in my room. You know, I was, unboxing, unpackaging everything I had gotten. And I look, and there's, like, in the sleeping bag, like, case that it came in, there was, like, a paper that like had the barcode that you would buy it at the store with or whatever, and then it had like the description of what it was and all that good stuff. Well, above the barcode it said walmart.com. I was so mad at my mom, like I didn't even want to talk to her. I literally wrote her a letter and I was like, why does my present from Santa Claus say walmart.com? And she like wrote me back, like homegirl knew she was busted, but like she wrote me back and she was like, well, the elves were just really busy this year, so they had to get a little help from the stores because they just couldn't do it all themselves. And I just was not buying it. And I'm pretty sure that's the moment I was like,
Santa Claus isn't real.
My whole life was over because Santa Claus wasn't real, because he got me a sleeping bag that said walmart.com on it. So if you're a parent and you're watching this, make sure you cut all the tags off. Because if you have a nosy and I don't even know the word for it kid like I was, then they're gonna catch on that it's not from Santa. So just a little heads up. Do you wear pajamas or do you dress up on Christmas? So Christmas morning, obviously I'm in my pajamas, but like if we go to like a family dinner or like any other family get together, I dress like kind of cute. Like I don't dress like to the nines by any means, but I do dress up a little bit at least. And then the very last question is, after Christmas, do you make New Year's resolutions? And if so, do you stick to them? So I'll be honest, usually I don't make New Year's resolutions just because I feel like it's so basic and like, why do you have to wait till the new year to better yourself kind of thing? So I would say no, I don't make New Year's resolutions necessarily, but I do think of things like even throughout the year that I'm like, hey, but like by this time I would like to accomplish this. So one for me this year is, as you guys may know, I started a new job recently and I'm kind of like a caseworker, but we have all this training and stuff we have to go through before we actually get our own case. So we probably won't get our own cases until like February. So whenever that starts, I just like, my goal is to just, you know, so right now soak in all the information I can about what I'm going to be doing. And then whenever that time comes, just to be the best caseworker I can personally be. Not only for myself to make it easier on myself and my workload, but also for my clients that I deal with so that the process and things like that will be smooth for them. And also I'm a very hard worker, like not even trying to be like egotistical, but I'm typically a very hard worker. So I just want to prove to myself that I will be good at this since it is my first big girl job. I want to know that like I can do this, like I got this. Like, yes, I went to college and graduated and got a degree, but like I can actually do this. So that's one of my bigger goals, I would say, in the next year. And then just trying to save money for the wedding and to pay off my student loans, because that is so important right now because they are so expensive. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this little Christmas tag and I hope you guys are enjoying this Vlogmas series. I can't wait to show you what else I've done this Christmas season. And yeah. So if you like this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up as well as hit the subscribe button down below. I would love to have you join the little YouTube fam. I'm slowly but surely growing, not nearly as fast as I would like to, but can't complain. I'm having a lot of fun doing this. So I hope you guys are enjoying these videos as much as I am enjoying making them. So yeah, I will see you guys in my next video.